So students, today I'm going to show you how to solve these quant-based questions in a matter of 30 seconds. Also students, don't forget to stick to the end of this video, because at the end I'll ask you a similar kind of question which can be based on either this one or this one. And the answer of that you will mention in the comment section below. After checking your answers, I will let you know whether they are right or wrong. And in case they are wrong, don't worry, I'll explain you the same. Okay? So let's talk about the first question. Okay, the first question is, if 1 upon 5 raised to m into 1 upon 4 raised to 18 is equals to 1 upon 2 raised to 10, the whole raised to 35. Or rather, 2 into 10, the whole raised to 35. Okay, before beginning with this term, I would like to talk about this particular concept. Okay, so when you have, let's say, 3 raised to 2n is equals to 81. Okay, so I can write this as nothing but 3 raised to 2n is equals to 3 raised to 4. So I can now directly compare 2n with 4. Why? Because both the bases have become same. Before that, you could not have done it. Okay, so please don't make the mistake of these certain basics of indices. Students, if you don't understand the indices topic or you have a lot of confusion in the basics of indices, and please comment so in the comment section. I will make a video of that as well. And not just indices, if you have any particular other topic whose knowledge or whose understanding is not very clear to you, then please go ahead and write down in the comment section, or as you can email me also these topics. Most of you all actually do email me certain topics, and because of that I keep making these kind of videos as well. So do go ahead and do that. I will make a video on that particular topic also. So now here, like I said, that now 2 raised to 2n can be directly compared with 4. So we can now therefore say 2n is equals to 4. Therefore n is equals to 2. Okay, so this particular knowledge has to be important for solving this particular sum. Now this is 1 upon 5 the whole raised to m. So I can write this as nothing but 1 raised to m and upon 5 raised to m. Into, can I write this as nothing but 2 raised to 18 into 2 raised to 18, because 4 is nothing but 2 raised to 2 into 2, correct, is equals to 1 upon 2. Let's write this in terms of its prime factor. So we know it is 2 raised to 35 into 5 raised to 35. Got it? So now this looks like really very simple, okay, because this says, can I say 2 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 35? So that becomes, according to law of indices, m raised, a raised to n, m into a raised to n is equals to a raised to m plus n, correct? So this becomes 2 raised to 36, and this is also 2 raised to 36. So I can directly strike that out. And 1 raised to anything will always be 1, we know that. So this one and this one will get cancelled. So now what you're left with is 5 raised to m, which is equal to 5 raised to 35. So now can I directly say, using this particular logic, since the bases are same, I can now say that m is 35. Understood, students? Students, please understand, these questions are really very easy to solve, and I don't want any one of you all losing marks in the topic of indices, okay? So if you really have any doubts, don't feel afraid, don't feel shy, you can directly put it in your comment. Nobody's going to judge you, okay? That's the beauty of social media, or rather online teaching, okay? So you can do that, okay? And now, another thing I would like to tell all of you all is, please understand, if you like the way I'm explaining, then do go ahead and hit the like button, because when you hit the like button, that gives me tremendous amount of encouragement in doing these kind of videos, okay? Another thing, students, when you hit the like button, the YouTube algorithm understands that these videos are important for whoever is looking for math content online. So what it does is, it keeps showing these kind of videos to people who are interested in mathematics or who are interested in quant-based questions. Okay, so in a way you will be helping those people as well. Okay, so don't forget to hit the like button until it turns blue. Okay, now let's talk about the next question, which is, if n is a positive integer, then the least value of n for which n factorial is divisible by 1000 is what? So for this particular question, students, we will go through the options. Okay, now first thing first, 1000 can be written as what? 10 into 10 into 10. And let's, and as we know, the factor or the prime factorization of 10 is nothing but 2 into 5. Again, we'll repeat it. And we'll repeat it one more time. Why? Because 10 was getting multiplied thrice. So here I can say we need 2 cube and we need 5 cube. I mean, our 2 cube is 8. So you will take that answer or the least value. So you have to go from top to bottom. Okay. Or you will have to select those options which are the smallest. And if that is not convenient or if that is not satisfying this particular situation, then we go to the number which is a bit higher than that. Okay. Don't start from the biggest number because there you will make a mistake. Okay. So now again, 1 factorial is 1, which we know that that is not going to be possible. Okay. Now, 4 factorial, of course, can solve this 2 cube wala issue. But what will happen is, it does not have any 5 terms. So we need a number, we need a factorial which will have 5 terms as well. And that too, those terms have to be at least mentioned thrice. Okay, so here I can't take this, I can't take this. Now here, for 9 factorial, we could have taken it, but the problem is again, 5 just happens to be coming in 9 factorial only once and we need it to be coming at least twice. So here also, this is not possible. Now, coming to 15 factorial. Yes, 15 factorial can be taken into consideration. You know why? Because here you get 5, you get 10 as well and you get 15. So this gets multiplied, or rather this is can be said as 2 into 5. This can be said as 3 into 5. So we needed 5 to be coming how many times? 3 times. And as we can see, this coming 1, 2 and 3 times. And we don't really need to bother about 2 cube, which is 8, because in 15 factorial, you will start from 15 multiplied by 14, 13, 12, 11, 9, 8, 11, 10, 9 and 8. So 8 always comes into 15 factorial. So that is not my concern. Only your concern was that you needed a 5 happening thrice at least in the factorial. So here I can say that D is my answer. Okay, students, I hope this particular concept is now very, very clear. Okay, and don't forget to mention in the comment whatever topic you would want me to make a video on. Okay, now coming to the point of putting the question, whose answer you will mention in the comment section. So now, if I'm not going to write down the whole question, but this is the same question being repeated and you need to check for the divisibility test of 2500. So now, let me know which answer will suffice of the 5 options given over here. Okay, students, so that's it for this video. I will see you in the next one. Thank you.